Okay. Yeah, thank you, Larry. And there is a question from Fayaz, like, is that dot an operator or something in Java? It's like you are accessing that one. To access it, you should put a dot. Okay, whenever you create, so it's like an operator only, dot operator, we can say. The moment you put dot, this is how you will access it. Once you create your object, you have to put this particular op. I won't say it is an operator because operator we will say as a plus operator, minus operator, like that. So this dot is needed. Dot is needed to access whatever you have declared inside this class. Okay. Okay, great. So this is what is called as an object and a class. Okay, now we can move on to the next slide. So in that it has written like method and constructor. So what is a method and what is a constructor? Okay, let's see what is a method. So method in Java is a collection of statements that are grouped together to perform an operation. A method can produce some value or return some value. Okay, if a method is returning some value, then the type of the value that a method can provide or return is written on the left side of the method name. When it does not, then method is to be declared as void method. Okay, so just don't confuse with this statement. I'll explain you, then we will come back to this definition, then we will understand it better. Okay, in the previous slide, I told you, right, an object can have a state and behavior. So state is nothing but a variable and behavior is nothing but a method. So the action that it performs, that is what is called as a method in Java. What action it is going to perform. So you can declare variables, you can declare methods, anything in a class. Okay, so here in a mobile, we'll see. First we create a mobile class, right? Let's see how we can write a method. This is a syntax of a method. Whatever you are declaring, it should be in the class level. Okay, inside the class you write all the things you will be accessing inside this main method by creating an object. So remember these steps. So I'm going to declare a method. What is the syntax of that? I'll write it, then I'll explain. Public void method name. So mobile, I'll write it as calci. Okay, and opening and closing bracket, opening and closing braces. Okay, so what it is, this is a syntax of a method. So public again is an access modifier, it is available everywhere. Void is a return type. I'll tell you what is the return type. Here also we are saying void. Why? Because it is not returning anything. That is what it means. Calci is a method name. Okay, so this is going to be the access modifier. This is a return type and this is method name. It can be anything and this should be the syntax of a method and it should have this opening and closing bracket and this curly braces. Inside this you will be writing or you will be writing some quotes. So just let me give a system.out.println and here I am printing, I am typing Samsung can be used for calculation. Simply I am writing, this is my method. Okay, I just wrote my method calci. Inside that I just gave a printer print system.out.println as this one. So whenever I call this method, this should be printed by default. Okay, how do I call this method? Anyone? Exactly. So I have the object already created. I'll put a dot. The moment you put, you are seeing, see calci. Before calci was not there because we haven't declared it. Just now we declared it, right? So calci has come. Just double click on it. That's it. You don't have to write a system.out.println because this is a method which is going to perform some action. I'll just execute it. See what is the output? This Samsung comes from this mobile name variable and here I have the output of this method. So how it will happen when this class file loads, how I'll tell you how the control will flow. When this class file will load, first JVM will check for main method. This is the first step. Okay, then what is the second step? Here it will come here. It will see, okay, oh, this guy has created an object to this class. Where is this class? It is over here. Okay, so the next line it will come, third line. In third line it will see, okay, for using this object he has called the mobile name. Where is the mobile name? He will just fetch this value over here and he will put it under system.out.println and it will show you. What is the fourth line? So control will come over here. Here you have used that object and you have called the calc. So when you called it, control will come over here in this action. What is you have written in this action? You have printed Samson can be used for calculation. So this will be printed. So this is how the execution flow will happen when you write a program and execute it. Clear or you want me to explain it again? Guys, are you clear with the flow, how it is happening when you have a Java program, how the control will flow? Okay. Vani, yeah, sure, I can, rather than pasting this in a notepad, I'll be sharing all the projects which we are practicing in our session as a project to you. End of the session, this program itself will be shared with you. Okay. Rather than pasting everything in a notepad, this is how we are doing actually. So we will give it as a project to you, so you can just import that into your Java and you can make use of it. Okay. Okay. Thank you. Now let's see one more thing. We have saved it, right? Let's go to our local location, whether it has the changes or not. Where is the local location? It is in my E drive, training demo 1, Java day 1. Inside src, inside demo 1 package. See, and now I have two classes. One is dog.java, one is mobile.java. And when I right click it and edit with notepad plus plus, whatever you have written in Eclipse, you are able to see it, right? So this will be saved in your local. When you come back, you have something called bin, right? Previously it was empty, nothing was there. If you go here, even bin is having something. What is having? It is having demo 1. What is demo 1? It was the package name we provided, right? Demo 1 was the package name we provided. Inside this, if you go, you are seeing something like dog.class and mobile.class, right? We haven't saved it as .class. It got saved as .java, right? But in src, it was fine. It was like as we are seeing over here. But when you go to this bin directory, it was having something like dog.java, .class and mobile.class. And when you edit this with notepad plus plus and open, you're not able to read anything. It's not in human understandable format, right? So why it is happening? So this is because when you write a program, example mobile.java, and when you save it, saving is called as compiling. Okay, in Java the term is compilation. If you are compiling without any error, means you are saving without any error. Saving is nothing but the control S, press control plus S button. That is nothing but save, as we do in our regular notepad. So that is nothing but, in technical terms, you will see, okay, the compilation has done without any issue. Okay, so when you save this mobile.java, it will automatically convert into mobile.class by JVM, which is nothing but the Java virtual machine. Why? Because this .java is in a language which will convert into this .class format. It is in byte actually, which the machine can understand. Okay, so this JVM can understand this ones and zeros, right? So machine, it will convert this .java file into .class file when you save it. So this .class file is the one that you will hand over to your client. You will not give, I'll show you how you will give a end of this session, probably end of this course, I'll show you how you will hand over your project into your client. You will not give your .java file because it is readable. Anyone can make use of it. Anyone can copy it. Anyone can make changes in it, right? If you are giving something like this, everyone can see it. So it's a regular practice. People will give only this .class file because it's not in human readable format. We are seeing it, right? It's in machine language, okay? So this is the one JVM will understand. So the moment you save it, it will convert that into .class file, and this is the one which will be executed by your Java program. Clear? Okay. Now, I told you this is going to be a syntax of a method, right? So a method syntax. I'll just paste it over here. Okay, so this is going to be the syntax of a method. So what is this? Public again is going to be the access modifier. Public means it is available everywhere. Void is a return type. What is a return type? Say for example, if I am giving you a number called 4. What is the data type of it? We are seeing it. What is the data type? Exactly. It's an integer. Okay. And I am giving a variable name called a equals 4. Okay. Similarly, if I am having another variable called b which is equal to 5. Again, the data type is integer. If I am asking you to multiply these two, A into B, what is the answer of it? It is going to be 4, 5 is 20, right? So this is also going to be the integer. So this is the return value of the multiplication, right? These both value, when it got multiplied, it returned an integer. So the return type is also going to be an integer. That is what is called as a return type. So if you are mentioning this return type here instead of void, if you are mentioning as int, which means this has some action which will return the output in data type as integer. If I am mentioning this as string, which means this method calci has got some action and the output is going to be as a string, and it is going to return the output as a string. Okay, if I am mentioning it as void, which means it is not returning anything, instead it is just printing something. If you are returning something, if you are writing int over here, then you don't have to write this one. Instead, you should have a return statement like this, return something. So this return will say, for example, here, if I am writing integer a is equal to 4 and integer b is equal to 5, then int, let it be the sum equals, what is the sum? A plus b, right? That is the sum. So what I should return? I should return the sum. Okay, so when I run it, I should print it over here. Okay, just let me write it, then I'll explain. I'll execute it. When I executed it, I got the answer as 9. 4 plus 5, 9. So what I changed over here, previously it was void and it was returning only some system.out.println, right? I was not returning any value. But here I just changed the return type as integer, which means this method has got some actions to perform and the output is going to be an integer data type. So what I'm going to calculate, I'm going to calculate the sum of two numbers, integer type. So I'm returning the sum value. Sum of course is an integer. Okay. So when you call that method and print it, you will see the output over there. Okay. So is it clear when you have a return type? Okay, great. So similarly, if you are using a string in return type, which means you have an action to perform and the result of that action is going to be a string, and you have something like float, double, and all. Okay, float is nothing but it will be having a decimal value inside it, and double means it, if you are having a very large value to store, then you will be using double as a data type. Okay, in double, float, all these are integer data type. Int is there, then you have got string data type is there, float is there, double is there. These are various data types. Okay, so this is how you will declare a method. This is a method declaration with return type. Okay, now how you will have a method declaration without a return type? I'll just make another one, calci one, because for your future reference I'm writing. This is a method declaration with return type as void. Void means nothing. As the word means, it is nothing. Okay, so I'll just remove this calculation and just printing something. It's not going to return anything. Okay, so these two methods we have now. One is having declaration with return type as void, and here I just kept it as integer. Okay, so that in future you can refer it. So is it clear what is a method, what is a variable, what is a class, what is an object and all? Great, great. Okay. So just practice it, guys. Once the session is over, just practice all those things. Try creating your own classes. Try writing some method. Try doing some actions. Try to call it as. Then you will get more familiarized with this. Just replay this video again and again. Okay. So you will, because this concept should be thorough. This is a basic. This is a foundation of your programming. We will be doing everything based on this only. Okay. Okay. Fine. And what is the next thing we saw? Now if you read this statement, you will come to know. Okay, let's just read it, then we will come to know. Previously we read it, we did not understand anything, right? We just understood what is a method. Let's read it again. A Java method is a collection of statements that are grouped together to perform an operation. Fine. A method can produce some value or return some value. We have seen it, integer. If a method is returning some value, then the type of the value that a method can provide or return is written on the left side of the method name. Isn't it? See, what is the method name over here? Calci is the method name. On the left side, we have given the return name. Correct. When it does not, the method is to be declared as a void method. Now it's clear, right? Okay. So, next is a constructor. What is a constructor? Okay, we have seen a method. Next is a constructor. Constructor is like a brother to this method, almost similar with some difference. We will see what is that difference. A constructor is a special method that is used to initialize the object. Okay, so a constructor is something which is used to initialize the object. Okay, so rather than initializing, I will add two more points over here. Okay, in this running note, I am adding constructor. What was the first point? It is used to, okay, why it is having underline? It is used to initialize the object. What is another point? It's a special type of method. We already seen it. It will be invoked, I'll tell you what it is. I'll write it and I'll explain you. At the time of object creation. Okay. Another point, it construct values for an object, and that's why it's called as a constructor. It says like it will create values for an object, that is a way it will construct value for an object. You have created an object, right? So this constructor can be used to create a value for it. That's a reason it is called as constructor. Another point, constructor name is same as class name. How it can happen? How constructor name and class name can be same? We will see it. Constructor is a special type of method only. Nothing but a special type of method. And another point I'll add, it will not have any return type, not even void. You don't have to specify anything. That is how in Java constructor is defined. So these are the specification of a constructor. It is used to initialize an object. It will be invoked. Invoked means it will be called or initiated, anything you can tell, at the time of object creation. Okay. It construct value for an object. That's the reason it is called as a constructor. And the name of constructor will be same as the class name. It will not have any return type, not even void. We will see how to define a constructor. Let's go to this mobile class itself. What is a class name? Mobile. So I'm going to create a constructor. So what we have seen, constructor name should be same as this class name, right? I'm just writing class name. It is not having any return type. Okay, just let me give it as public. Public is not the return type. Instead, it is an access modifier, and I'm giving like this. That's it. It's similar to your method declaration only. See how you declared method. Same way, you just give a method name. There will be some return type, either an integer or a void or a string. Here, you not even void it has. So no return type is needed, and the name of the constructor is going to be the same as the class. Okay, so whatever class name is there, the name should be the same as the class name. And here I'm giving as access modifier public, because it should be available everywhere. Similarly, I'm just giving a printout over here. Inside, let's print like inside constructor. Okay, I'll save it. Now, how do we access it? Any idea? How do we access it? Because the class name is same, right? Can you just guess it? How do you access it? It's inside this class only. It is nothing but a method only, a special type of method you are using inside the class level. See, like Calci, you have mobile over here. Okay, here how you Calci you accessed using your object name, right? So this particular mobile constructor, how you will access in your main method. I just want to print this line. Whatever is given inside this, I want to execute and print it. Any idea, any guesses? Just give a trial how we can give it. Not exactly, yeah, using class, like can you elaborate how using a class? Class, of course, we have, right? We have a class and we need to create an object to it. We should use a class for that, right? So what I should write to execute this code, this particular piece of code? This is our main method. So what I should write here? Let's see two more points once again. Okay, it constricts values for an object, that's why it is called as a constructor. It will be invoked or called at the time of object creation. Okay, see here, you have created an object already, right? And mobile is nothing but your class. At the same time, that is going to be your constructor. You don't have to create it separately. Why? Because this constructor was initialized when you created object to it, because it is having the same name. So here what is happening? Initiating constructor, isn't it? Because mobile is going to be your constructor, right? Mobile is your constructor, which is sharing the same name as your class name. And when you created an object to your class, it is nothing but you are initializing your constructor, right? You don't have to call it separately. So when I just execute this one, see, inside constructor got printed. Why it got printed? I haven't called that it like this. I haven't called it, right? Only mobile name and Calci I called. I did not call it as something dot mobile. I did not do it. Why I did not do it? Because my constructor got initialized by creating an object to the class. You don't have to give anything separately. It will be initialized when you create an object to the class. That is the reason a constructor and a class is having the same name. Clear this point? Any doubt? Faiz, I think you are having doubt. Is it clear now? Okay. The practical use of this one is you can create. Okay, thank you, Faiz. So there's another question like, what's the practical overall reason to create it? Okay, I can show you one better example. Okay, so I'm just going to create a class called student. It is nothing but it will create values to your object. Okay, that is the reason we are using constructor. So say for example, I'm having student, a regular student. Okay, this particular student hasn't participated in any of the extracurricular activity, so he is not going to get any grace mark. Okay, and there is another student with grade A, means this particular student participated in some of the extracurricular activity and she or he is going to get an extra mark of 20. Okay, when the student get grade A, which means he will get an extra mark of 20. And there is another student called grade B. With grade B means this particular student also participated in some of the extracurricular activity. With the grade B, she or he is going to get an extra mark of 10. This student hasn't participated in anything, so he is not going to get any extra mark. So if this is the base mark, this grade A will be having mark plus 20. Why? Because he already got a grade of A. This student, which already got a grade of B, is going to get the mark plus 10. Okay, so this case is clear, right? I'm just taking three students. One student is a regular student who just got the mark. This is a baseline mark. And this student with grade A got an extra mark of 20. And this student with grade B got an extra mark of 10. Okay, so now I'm going to make use of my constructor to construct values for these different cases. I'll just write it, see it, okay? I'll explain it, what I mean, how it is working, all those things. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to declare three variables, integer, max, max. I'll explain what it is. Then integer, max with grade A. Okay, then integer marks with grade B. Okay, three things I have. What these three denotes? It denotes the mark of this regular student, student with grade A and student with grade B. So I need to construct these three values. If I am giving you only this mark, you should be able to construct value for this student. You should be able to construct value for this as well, because mark is going to be the common in all the places, right? So I'm going to write a constructor called, how to declare a constructor. The name of the constructor should be same as the class, and here I'm going to pass a parameter called maximum or simply base mark. Okay, now this maximum mark, so what is this maximum mark? This is a variable I'm just assigning to this student. This variable I'm assigning to this student. This variable I'm assigning to this student. So mark means this maximum mark. Max mark grade A means mark plus 20. Okay, so what is this marks? Max mark, he is a regular student which is not having any of the extracurricular activity. So she is going to get the base mark only, right? That's it. What is mark with grade A? She is going to get, or she or he is going to get, this base mark plus 20 extra. And what is this mark grade B? She is going to get an extra mark of 10 from this base mark, right? So I have my constructor now. So now what I'm going to have, I'm going to have some other methods to print this value. This is just an action. This is just an, some calculation it is performing inside. I should print it, right? So for printing, what I'm going to do, I'm going to write some methods called public void print mark of regular student. This is a method name I'm just giving for, so that we will understand what it represents. What will be the mark of regular student? SYSO control space. Okay, so here inside this I'm writing mark of regular student as, what is the mark of regular student? Is going to be the maximum marks, isn't it? This is the maximum mark which he is going to get, right? Similarly, I'll just, yes, it is case sensitive files. It is, of course, case sensitive. Java is case sensitive, so you should be very careful actually. Okay, and print marks of student with grade A. Okay, so here I'm changing as student with grade A. So what is that student with grade A? Is going to get the mark this one, right? I'll just copy this again. Here student with grade B, and here I'm changing this as B, and this one also should be the same as this one. This is just a printing. Okay, now what I should do, how I will call this method? I just have a class now. This is a class. Inside this class I have a constructor. I have this methods, three methods. How do I print it? Guys, anyone, how do I print it? Of course, I should have a main method. So I'm writing public static void main string parameters. What is the parameter? Arguments I need to pass. Inside this, Now, what is the next thing I should do? How do I access this one? Of course, I should create an object. So student, let it be st equals new. I should create an object, right? See, when you type student, it is itself showing you some suggestion. What is a suggestion? Student, it will accept some mark, right? It is not simply giving you the student class, right? Instead, it is invoking your constructor. So far we haven't seen it, right? We are creating an object to this class. But when you are creating an object to that class, what it is doing, it is trying to invoke this constructor. See here, the moment you type student and press control plus space, what it is doing, it is giving you suggestion student, and it is asking to put the base mark over there. It is asking you to enter some mark over there. So if you put the mark as 30, why? Because 30, it will accept an integer. So when I execute it, sorry, I should print it, right? To get the print, what I should do? I should call this method. How I will call the method? st.print mark of a regular student. st.print mark of the student with grade A. We have three methods, right? Mark with grade B. This is for printing. So now I am going to execute this program. See the output. Mark of a regular student is going to be 30. And what is the student with grade A is going to get 50, 20 mark extra. And grade B student is going to get 10 mark extra, 40. So what it is doing over here, so far we have, when we created an object, was it asking for some parameter? No, right? But here, when you created an object to this particular class student, it asked for a parameter, integer parameter for 30. Why? Because it was initiating the constructor there. When you have a constructor, we already wrote that one. When it will be invoked, your constructor will be invoked or called at the time of object creation. So that's the reason when you are creating itself, it is asking you to feed some input. What is that input? An integer input. So how the control will flow over here? When the program loads, first, of course, one second, first what it will be, control will come into this point, public static void main. Now it will come here, next line. This will be the first line, this will be the second line. So here it will see, okay, he has got created some object. And by seeing this, you'll understand, okay, there is a constructor being called which will accept the parameter called 30. So next what it will do, the control will go to here. Here it will come, the control will come over here, that instead of base mark, 30 will come in place of this. 30 will come over here, int 30. Okay, so what will be the maximum mark? It is going to be 30, which is the value over here. And grade A will be 30 plus 20, grade B will be 30 plus 10. And those values will come in this place when you call this method, system.out.println. Next line is this one. So the control will come next to this line. So what is this printing? It's nothing but this one. And what is you are printing? Maximum mark, which is the base mark, that is 30. Similarly, next you call to print this one. What is that method? It is nothing but maximum mark with grade A, that is nothing but base mark plus 20. Similarly, grade B, maximum mark with grade B is base mark plus 10. So it will print you and it will show you the result. So is it clear now why we are using a constructor? This is the best example actually. You will understand why we use a constructor. Yeah, of course, Lucy. Yeah, what's the question? Yeah, you can have multiple constructors, but the arguments parameter that you are passing inside should be different. That will come in another concept when what we have in overloading. Okay, so in overloading we will see it how we can overload it. So we will see it in our next topic. So yeah, fine. So we will explain it how we can override a constructor, all those things. Okay, so one more thing I need to tell you. See here, you have created a constructor, right? But there was no arguments inside this, right? Mobile was there, you just created a constructor called mobile again inside it, and when you called it, nothing, no parameter was called inside this. So this is called as a default constructor. Okay, and in student, what you have done, you have a class called student. And inside that, you just wrote a method, a constructor, a student, which will accept some parameter of integer data type. So this is a parameterized constructor. Okay, so this is called a default constructor, and this is a parameterized constructor. Okay, I'll just write it over here. So this is called as a even if you have commented this one, by default you can say a constructor is being called. Is it? See here, I just commented it, right? There is no constructor created with the name mobile, but still you are creating an object to this class, which means you are internally initiating a constructor. Got this point? Because if you had a constructor, if you had a constructor that would be having the name of mobile, right? Here you commented it. You are not commenting as nothing, but you are just not using it. Okay, you can comment it. If you want to comment it, a single line comment is like this. You can just put double slash over here. And if you want to comment an entire block, just select it, press Ctrl plus Shift plus forward slash. And to uncomment it, Ctrl plus Shift plus backslash. Okay, so to comment it, I'm just selecting this entire line, Control Shift forward slash, so it will get commented. So once you comment it, it is not active, which means this method doesn't exit. That is the meaning of a comment. You're commenting this piece of code, but still when you're creating an object to this particular class, means you are calling a default constructor, initiating a default constructor. Why I'm saying default constructor? By default it is constructing something called mobile. By default it is calling some, say for example, if I'm not initiating this value, I'm just putting like this, okay, I just deleted mobile name from here, so what will be the value of this Samsung.mobile name? Let's see it. It is not giving anything, right? It is just giving empty to you, right? One second. If I am just giving like this, see, it is giving null. Why? Because null is the default value of a string. Okay, I'll just make a point over here. Default value of string is null. Similarly, for integer, default value is zero. Okay, So what it is, why I am writing like this, I just previously I assigned a value like Samsung to it, right? So I just removed it and I just gave a variable name. I'm not assigning any value to it. Okay, I don't give to any value to it. I'm not going to give any value to it, but simply I just assigned it a value called mobile name. That's it. So when I am not assigning any value to a variable, when you are creating an object to the class, a constructor, what is the job of a constructor? It will construct value for an object. We have seen it, right? It construct value for an object, and that is why it is called as a constructor. How does it construct? At least it will construct a default value to it. Though you are not having your constructor over here, the moment you called this particular line, Samsung.mobile, when you printed, it came as null. Why? Because when you wrote this line, you initiated a default constructor which constructed a default value to the variable mobile name as null. Is this point clear? Yeah, every class will have a default constructor files. So it's not, you should say a default constructor. Why? Because even if you are not declaring anything, what is a constructor? Basically, that is going to be the same name of your class only, right? So when you are initializing an object to that class, it is nothing but it is something similar to you are calling that particular constructor, right? So you should say every class will have a default constructor. Is it clear to you, Larry and Fires, now? Okay. Similarly, if I am giving here another mobile string, say int price of mobile, okay, I'm just giving as, sorry, not string, int price, I'm not initializing anything over here, okay, and if I'm not initializing anything over here, and if I'm trying to call it as, what is the variable name over here, you should press control space and price is there, I just left it price. And if I'm running it, you should be able to see zero. So why? Because zero, since I haven't assigned any value to this price, it is taking zero as your default value and it got assigned to this particular variable. This was done by your default constructor. So when you haven't declared anything, a default constructor will be called. And if you have purposefully declared it, whatever called inside it, that will get executed. That's it. Otherwise, it will assign the default value. It will construct default value to the object. Clear the concept of constructor and methods? Any doubts, guys? If you, so far what we have discussed, so we went through object and class, what is an object, what is a class, how to declare it, and what is a variable, what is a method, how to declare it, what is a return type, and what is a method and constructor. So basically this is another interview question. In interview they may ask like, what is the difference between a method and a constructor? So you should be able to differentiate between these two. Now you know, right, like what is a method, how to declare it, and what is a constructor? It's a special type of constructor, right? So you should be able to write or tell all these points. So this will be an interview question. Like, what is the difference between a method and a constructor? Okay. If they ask you to write a constructor, of course you can write something simple like this, a mobile class or a dog class. Or if you are writing this one, it will make a good impression because it is nothing but you are giving them a good example to construct value for your object. or you can take a default constructor as this and just show them the value what it shows. Okay. Okay guys, so next topic is method overloading. So even if I start it, I cannot finish it today. So probably we'll have this session next week, because it won't be it, you will not understand if I start if I make it half today and make it half another day. So better we will start it and finish it on the same day. So I'm not going to start this method overloading today. So do you guys have anything that to clarify today from the topics which we have covered? So far, just practice it, okay? I'll be sharing this recorded video session, everything with you. So practice it, just try writing all these steps. If you are facing any issue, of course you can ask me at any time, no issues. But so far what we have covered, if you have any doubt, you can very well ask me in a method or in a class or in an object, because these concepts should be very clear and thorough, because we'll be using this concept in our programming further. Everything will be based on this one only. That's the reason I'm stressing again and again. This one. Yeah. You have any question for us or? Yes, we have covered these two actually, methods and constructor and object and class. Okay, so method overloading, if we start, we cannot cover it. So that's the reason I'm not starting today. We'll have it on probably next week. So we can cover it on the same day. It will be good then. Otherwise, it will be like half of you cover today, half you cover next week. So the continuity will be lost. I don't want to make it messy. So that's the reason I'm not starting it today. Okay. There's a question from Bias, like, okay, this Eclipse has a connection to Selenium. Eclipse is a tool, basically, Bias. It's a tool. Eclipse is an IDE, integrated development environment, where you will type your code. Okay. So whatever you should have some, you cannot write in your notepad or Word, right? So you should have a tool which is integrated with your Java to write your programs, right? So this, whatever you're writing, everything is a keyword. See, this public class, everything is a keyword from Java. So why it is not showing any error when you are writing? Because it already contains JRE system library, and this library contains the definition of your Java keywords. Okay, so Eclipse is a tool which you will make use to do your programming. So the connection with Selenium is, it is nothing but where you will do the coding. So once you do the coding here, in this place only, you will make use of your Selenium. Exactly, Lucy, we are going to write our Selenium code in Eclipse only. Eclipse is a development environment, which I said, right? What is JDK? JDK is JRE plus some extra tools. So one of the tool is, you can say it as a Eclipse, where you will write your code. So when I use Eclipse, what I will do, now I have only this Java JDK library. I will add Selenium library also here. I'll show you how it is. Once Java topics is over, I'll show you how to add that. If I add this Selenium library in this area, then you can make use of Selenium codes over here. You will write it in this index, same syntax. You will execute it, which will kickstart your application on the browser. Got it? So Eclipse is always needed, because it's a place where we do the coding of our program. Okay guys, so if there are no other question, probably we can wind up the session for today. Okay, there is another question. So far it was so good. Thanks for the simple and descriptive list. Yeah, thank you, Lucy. Actually, the thing is, what I repeat is like we should be thorough with the concept. So just replay the video again and again. Just try writing the code in your own Eclipse. Okay, just do let me know if you face any issue, and if in this topic, that's the reason I was slowly I was giving you examples, because when you if you go to your Google page also, they'll just give you some bookish definition. Okay, you will not understand it. Not you. If I am new to programming also, it will be hard for me to digest, right? So that's the reason I just put these simples over here. I tried to manipulate in that way so that it will stick to our mind better. Okay. So just go through it, everything. Try writing the programs. If you have any doubt, you can very well ask me. Okay. Thank you, Fayaz. Thank you. Thanks, everyone. So we will meet next week, same time. Okay. Yeah, sure. Everything like whatever I wrote, running documents and video, recorded video, you will get within 24 hours. And this programs, as I told, what we were doing is like end of the session, I'll just hand over this entire project itself. Okay, so this entire project, classes, everything will be there. So if I'm giving one by one, it will be messy. So if I'm giving the entire project, you can just make use of this Java file and you can utilize it. So if you want particularly, until then, whatever we have recorded so far, no, just replay it and get it. Okay, one by one, if you are giving, it will not be good. So as a project, whatever I am writing here is for our session only. So this entire package I will give you end of the session. Is that okay? Great. So guys, I'm just stopping the recording. Thanks for your time. Thanks for joining. We'll meet next week. Thank you.